Welcome. In this video, we're going to discuss the motion of the Earth and sky and examine some of the reasons of why we see certain patterns and objects move throughout the sky. If we remove the title and just look at the picture here, what you should be seeing are star trails, and these are taken in a special way in the sense that as a photographer is aiming his camera towards the sky, the shutter is left open, and then the motion of the Earth is captured onto the camera. So these are different star trails, and this, in fact, here is Orion. I could tell because of the three stars in the belt. And some of these other trails you might be seeing could be possible satellites that are hovering above the Earth's atmosphere. So we're going to look at why do we see these patterns, and what does it all mean? One of the most basic Earth motions that most people can identify with is where the sun rises and sets. Everywhere on the Earth, the sun rises in the east, but it sets in the west. But what does this actually mean about Earth's rotation? What it means is that the Earth is really spinning from west to east. So if we were to draw that on here, this is the direction in which the Earth is spinning every 24 hours. Another basic Earth motion that many are familiar with is how long it takes for the Earth to revolve around the Sun, or how long does it take for it to make one trip around the Sun? 365.2 days is a true amount of time it takes for the Earth to completely revolve around the Sun. That extra 0.25 days that is on each year eventually adds up to a full day, and that's when we have a leap year. So when you add up those 0.25 days over 4 years, we have a leap year, and we have an extra day in February on the 29th due to this phenomenon. You might also notice that the Earth is tilted. It's not completely straight up and down. There is an axial tilt of the Earth that is 23.5 degrees. And the importance of this is a reason that the Earth experiences seasons. Because the Earth is tilted, there's uneven heating of the Earth going on throughout the year, and therefore we see temperature and seasonal differences. Welcome. In this video, we're going to discuss the motion of the Earth and sky and examine some of the reasons of why we see certain patterns and objects move throughout the sky. If we remove the title and just look at the picture here, what you should be seeing are star trails, and these are taken in a special way in the sense that as a photographer is aiming his camera towards the sky, the shutter is left open, and then the motion of the Earth is captured onto the camera. So these are different star trails, and this, in fact, here is Orion. I could tell because of the three stars in the belt. And some of these other trails you might be seeing could be possible satellites that are hovering above the Earth's atmosphere. So we're going to look at why do we see these patterns, and what does it all mean? As we continue to study the Earth and its motions and how that reflects what we see in the sky, there are certain terms that I want you to be familiar with because they will continue to pop up as we learn about the constellations. So the first is a celestial equator, and you can see that as being represented by the dotted line all throughout here. And what this is the Earth's equator projected onto the night sky. And you can see that the celestial north pole, if you draw a line straight up, is pointing towards Polaris. Polaris being the North Star, which is part of the constellation Ursa Minor. So that's what the celestial equator is. But the ecliptic is the path of the sun through the sky, and this is traced out by the solid gray line here. Okay, and you can see that the ecliptic and celestial equator intersect on two different points, and these are the days of the equinox. The spring equinox is sometime between March 20th and 21st, and here it would be September 20th to the 22nd. It varies between each year. But just make sure you're familiar with what the ecliptic is and what the celestial equator is as we go through and continue to study how the sky appears to move and what we are seeing. So let's review what we know about the motion of the earth and sky. We know that the stars and sun rise in the east and set in the west, but the actual motion of the earth is from west to east. I liken this experience to when you're driving in a car and you're looking at the trees as you're going forward. It appears that the trees are moving backwards, but it's really you who are the one that is moving forward. So it's that sort of illusion. So we know the Earth revolves from west to east. Furthermore, we know that the Earth's rotation is 24 hours, but the Earth's revolution to make one complete trip around the Sun takes 365.25 days. Those extra 0.25 days over the course of 4 years gives us a leap year, and that's why we have February 29th every 4 years. And finally, we know the axial tilt of the Earth is 23.5 degrees, and this axial tilt is what causes the seasons on Earth. There's uneven heating on the surface throughout the year, causing temperature differences.